Yes, it costs money to fund these, but they have an enormous impact on students, and not many seem to notice that. In this speech, I'll first be giving some visuals of how students are generally with and without our education. Following that, I will be giving some real-life examples of how a music program has helped with the school. Then I will talk about some personal experience. Afterwards, I will give some more information from my research and some studies that have shown through with art education. After that, I will be talking about what others think about this topic, and lastly, I will talk about creative economy. First, imagine a student. This student doesn't live in a safe neighborhood. The parents drink all the time, they have depression and anxiety, they don't have many friends to talk to. Their school mainly focuses on math and science subjects. There's no art and there's no music. This student has no way to express themselves. Sure, the teachers would probably help them, but you can't always put depression into words or explain verbally what's going on inside your head. School stresses them out, so they skip all the time and their testing scores are low. This is generally what happens to a student in this situation. Now, imagine a different student in a completely different school. There's the normal math and science classes, but there's also music and art. This student is in the same situation as the one from before. The difference is they have been taught different ways to express themselves. They're getting better through their depression and anxiety, and their testing scores are great, which is what all schools want. This student is happier in life. Now, to give some real examples besides just imagining and visualizing, the New York Times, in an article called Fighting Poverty Armed with Violence, looks at Venezuela, one of the poorest countries in the world, and with some of the lowest GPAs. All the kids skip school, and even at age 5, they would be robbing stores. The crime rate was high, and the GPA rates were low. After a while, the government was smart and said, hey, we should try and bring the music into the school and have it for all the grades for free. All of this got funded by the government, the instruments, the learning tools, everything. The crime rate dropped from all of this and the GPAs got better instantly. Today, they have some of the best musicians, artists, professors, and scientists. By now you're probably wondering why I'm talking about this, and it's not just because I want to. I want to talk about this because I haven't had an art and music class since the fourth grade, which was at Fire Lake Elementary School. Just last year in eighth grade, my school, Oscanian Cultural Charter School, finally got a music teacher, and all of us had to learn everything that we had missed throughout the years because many of us had been at the charter school there. Honestly, I've been wanting an art class instead of the music class because I love to draw. And the only problem with me drawing is that I'm not to my full potential because I have not had as much teachings of different techniques to be able to get better through my drawing career. And to be honest, it's very difficult for me to talk about my feelings, so I try turning to art and drawing in order to express myself. And that's how I'm able to, how I'm still doing well in school. I have something to turn to when I don't know who to talk to or how to explain what's going on. I have found out that art education in our public schools has decreased since the 1980s. Why? Have we forgotten that art education is linked to academic achievement, social and emotional development, civic engagement, and equitable opportunity? Do we not realize that music can help those from other countries learn languages quicker than studying from a book? All of these seem to go unnoticed, and there's plenty of studies out there that show how art education helps students in school. For example, there was a study on high schoolers who were tracked for 3 years. Each of them were required to take at least one minimal credit for art. Those who decided to do more than that one credit were 1.5 times more likely to meet or exceed the ACT plan national average. Another study on music students' math test scores compared to non-music students were... Why? Not many realize this, but but there is a lot of math in music. You have to know whether something's done in like a half beat or a whole note or even an eighth note. It can get really confusing, but it can help with fractions. Now I'd like to talk about what others think about this topic. I have gone onto Facebook into this large social group I am in called Psych2Go Personal Development Group and asked them what their opinions are or different personal experiences that they have had on this topic. Ali Sikora Badu mentions drama helps those with behavior issues because it helps break up the day better rather than sitting at a desk for 6 hours a day, thus improving their behavior. And she also mentioned how she was very lucky to be able to grow up being able to go to a theater and seeing all the different experiences, and she wishes that everyone could experience this. However, that's not the case. She believes that it would be better for everyone to get the chance to be exposed to drama and give them a chance to see the potential career in acting. All of the different comments were very wonderful and they helped add to this speech. Dee Lee mentioned that art helps introverted students who are stressed to express their anger, sadness, or depression, which I fully agree and relate to. Just because a lot of people can say I'm sad or I'm angry doesn't mean that everyone can, which is why art is a good way to express yourself. And it's a simpler way and it's not stressing too much on people to figuring out the right words. Now I'd like to talk about what some people call creative economy. Creative economy is like a way of saying how there is a lot of creativity or art inside many jobs that we have today. And which is very true, there is a lot of creativity in the jobs that we have out there. Just think about it, like a video game company. They have to create different ideas and storylines for all their games and also figure out which kind of visuals they want in the game. For example, some games are super realistic and it seems like you're actually in the world that they present to you, and others are simple pixels that still a lot of people like. Another thing is like advertising. Just think about it. A lot of ads can catch your eye whether you are really wanting to get new glasses or to buy that new t-shirt or not. A lot of business companies, when they create presentations, they usually include a graph of some sort just to show how much they have done so far, which also needs at least a little bit of creativity to be able to produce this. And yeah, not many think that there are many jobs. As I'm showing you, there is a lot of jobs that have creativity in it, even the small level. And if people don't even have like small levels of creativity, they're most likely not able to create things in their mind or create new ideas to bring out to the world. And in conclusion to all of this, I believe that we need more art education in our schools because of how they help students and help with our future careers and how there's many levels of creativity in our jobs today. And a way that I think we can put more art education into our schools or to make it a bigger deal is to have more fundraisers going directly to our art education, or have more funding from the state going directly to our art education in our schools. I hope this helps open your eyes to why we need more art education. Thank you.